Hello everyone, welcome back to Mr. Random Generator. In this video, I will be showing you how you can upload your Deno modules into its dedicated registry. Actually, calling that is a registry is not a correct statement, because unlike Node.js or many other platforms, you don't upload it into a specific location. Anywhere can be used as a registry. But for Deno, actually, the way the things currently moving, they used basically GitHub as their registry. I know it sounds a bit odd at first when you hear that stuff, but it will make sense. So, what you're looking right there is a random username generator. Of course, I make a random generator. And it's really simple stuff. It basically has list of the adjectives and nouns and combines them to create a username. As you can see right there, it picks, it parses the nouns, parses the adjectives using those respective methods. And we also have a random integer generator method. And once the generate username method is called, a random adjective is selected and random noun is selected, then we combine them and return the result. And we obviously make all of these into a class and we export that. After that, to test that out, as you can see, by the way, all of those stuff are inside the Git repository of mine, so we'll come back to that in a second, but I really want to quickly mention that I created a, actually it's not a test, I know, but to check that if it is working properly or not. So I go ahead and write Deno, and I want to run test.ts. So let's see, why doesn't it? Obviously, we need to run that. And obviously, we need to give the allow read flag, because the main purpose of Deno is all about security. So that, and now it should work. As you can see, we got a username of neighborly touch. And if we run it again, kind-hearted fairies. So I know it's silly, but actually it works. Anyway, so I remove that from my repo. I don't want to be dirty or anyway like that. So now let's look up the Deno's third-party modules. As you can see, you have actually a really nice explanation right there. And if we go into the GitHub, not the Git, just direct GitHub. So as you can see, I have created a basically, this is my repo, and I want to be listed under the Deno database. So I just go over there, and now you can see we actually see every module listed right there. So what we want to do is to add our add on our own. So all the way to the bottom, and we actually need to put it in a alphabetical order, so don't want to go in. Why do I thought Deno always actually? I should be. PR should be your rug. Yeah, it should be here, I guess. Am I right? Yeah, I think am I right? Yeah. So
G and
yeah. G. Yeah, yeah, okay, okay. Now I'll get it. That is the correct spot. So I'll just go ahead and rug and like so. And inside it there, as you can see, we can mention type, owner, repo, and description. So we copy that, paste it there. Type is GitHub, obviously, and owner is your username, and repo is rug, and a description. Actually, I'll head out to the module then. Just copy that, the description, and paste it right there. So that would be it. If you and also you can add your basically kind of description and your intentions right there, and then click on propose file change, and it will send a basic pull request to the Deno website repository, as you can see right there. And if that is confirmed by the maintainers, it will be up and running. What I recommend you to do after that is you just update your README file in order to let the users know how to use your module. So that is one important thing to do, actually. So hope you guys like this video, and if that is the case, please make sure to hit the like button, and see you next time. Take care.